Morning students, in this lecture we'll see some examples wherein we will use DRMS principle to solve the questions. Okay, so initially we'll see an elevator problem. So here the elevator of mass 500 kilogram is moving upward with the constant acceleration. So acceleration is not given, however some its final velocity is given, acquires a velocity of 2 meter per second. So this is V after traveling a distance of 3 meters. So this is S. So U is 0 because it is starting from rest. So you have to find out A. So U is, you can use Newton's equation of motion for finding out A. Okay. What you have to find out is the find the pull in the cable during the acceleration motion. So pull in the cable or R is here to be found out. Okay, the same accelerator, same elevator, continuous motion, and for stopping. It stops from velocity, initial velocity of 2 meter per second, u is 2 meter, and comes to rest in t is equal to 2 seconds. So final velocity is 0 because it is rest. So v is 0. Okay. In this case also, deceleration is not given. You have to find out using Newton's law of motion. Okay. V minus v is equal to u plus at. You can use that equation. Second point. So the question is, you have to calculate the force transmitted by a man of mass 75 kilogram on the floor. So you have to find out the reaction on the floor when the man of mass 75 kilogram is standing on that. Okay, start with the first case, pull in the cable during the accelerator motion. So during the accelerator motion, the initial velocity was 0 because it starts from 0. Final velocity is given as 2 meter per second and distance traveled is equal to 3 meter. So you can use the Newton's law of motion, which is v square is equal to u square plus 2as. So you can find out what is a. Let's note it as a1. Okay, so solving this expression, you get a1 is equal to 0.67 meter per second square. Now we'll draw the pre-poly diagram for the problem. So the elevator is having a mass of 500 kilogram. Its weight is will be acting downward, w equal to mass into gravity, and the reaction on the tension on the pull will be acting on the cable will be acting upward, so we denote it as R, and acceleration is upward, so A1 is equal to 0.67 meter upward, and mass is, weight is 500 into G, mass into G. Okay, so in order to bring this into equilibrium, we have to add a inertia force opposite to acceleration, so M into S to be added downward. So taking all the sum of all the forces in the upward direction as 0, so R is equal to ma plus mg. So solving for m and g and a, we'll get reaction is equal to 5240. So you can see that it is slightly more than the weight of the elevator. Okay, so now let's see the second case. So herein it said that the lift comes to rest by constant deceleration, so the final velocity is 0, the initial velocity is 2 meter per second, and the time taken for stopping is 2 seconds. Okay, again the deceleration rate is not given, however you have to find it out. So v is equal, we will use v is equal to u plus at is equal to 0, so that you can find out what is a. So in this case deceleration denoted as a2. Okay, so we got deceleration is minus 1 meter per second square, which means that the direction of acceleration is downward, right? And here we also given the, we have to find out the reaction on the floor when the man of mass 75 kilogram is standing on the floor of the lift. Okay, so let's draw the free body diagram. So man is having a mass of 75, is standing on the elevator, so his weight will act downward. Okay, w is equal to mg, so 75 into 9.81 will be the weight acting downward. The reaction exerted by the force floor will be in the upward direction, so this has to be found out. Okay, R has to be found out, and it is shown that acceleration is actually a deceleration, which means that it is acting in the downward direction. So A is equal to 1 meter per second square in the downward direction. So in order to bring this problem in dynamic equilibrium, you have to apply a inertia vector force in the opposite direction of the acceleration. So we have to apply an upward MA. So enough word MA is applied. So now we have to find out the equilibrium for these three forces R, W and MA. Okay, so taking sigma Fy equal to 0, we get R plus Mg equal to MA2 and R is equal to Mg minus MA2. Okay, substituting we get reaction is equal to 660.75, which means that we have got a reaction slightly less than the weight of the person standing on the ground. Clear? Now let's see another example. So this is a connected body problem. So here we have two bodies A and B of masses 80 kg and 20 kg respectively, and it is pulled towards left side by a force of 400 newton, and the in between is a connection of a thread. Okay, A and B is connected by a thread, which means that this will be having some tension in the thread. Fine. Also, it is given that the coefficient of friction between the sliding surface is 0.3, which means that when the body is moving on the left side, we will experience a friction in the opposite direction. So this also has to be taken into account. Okay. So the question is, you have to find out the tension in the thread as well as the acceleration of the bodies using D'Alembert's principle. So the first thing you have to do is free body diagram for both. So it is given that both of them are moving to left side, so we split the body into two system into two bodies. Okay, so the first body is having a weight mass of 80 kg, which means that it is having a weight of 18 to 9.81 acting downward. The reaction on the first body will be acting directly upward, so that is R1, and a tension of a pull of 400 is given on the left hand side, which means that the body will try to move in this direction. Okay, due to which the friction will be acting on the opposite direction. So F1 will be acting in the opposite direction here towards right. Okay, also a tension in the thread will be towards the center of the thread, so tension is towards right again. Okay, so the acceleration will also be in the right hand side, towards right hand side, right? Now if you take this free body diagram for the second one, the mass is acting downward, sorry, weight is acting downward, which is equal to 20 kg into 9.81. okay, the reaction will be acting directed upward. Okay, there is a tension in the cable which is towards the center of the cable, so tension will be towards the left, and since the motion is towards left, there will be a frictional force towards the right, which is equal to F2 is equal to mu into R2. Okay, that was a free. Now let's try to incorporate or apply our D'Alembert's principle by including the inertia force vector. Okay, so if you take the first free body diagram, the acceleration towards left, which means that we have to include an inertial force towards the right. Okay, and both will be equal to mass into acceleration. So first, for first one, mass is 80 kg, and for the second body, the mass is 20 kg. So 80 into A and 20 into A will be the inertial force vector to be applied on the direction opposite to the acceleration on both the bodies or on both the free body diagrams. So this is our final system. Okay, so in this case, if you want to find out R1, R1 will be directly equal to weight, okay, which is 18 into 9.81, right? So R1 is 18 to 9.81, which is 784.8 newtons. Second one, if you want to find out the friction F1, it is mu into R1. So mu was given as 0.3, R1 is 784.8, you get friction as 235. Now, in order to obtain the equilibrium, only thing you have to do is you have to find the sum of force in the horizontal direction as 0. So F1, T, MA and 400 Newton pull should also, everything should be together equal to 0. So F1 plus T plus MA minus 400 equal to 0. So substituting and simplifying, we have the first equation in terms of T and acceleration, which are unknown quantities. Okay, so we will leave that. Now we'll move to the second free body diagram. So here also R2 is equal to weight, which is R2 is equal to 20 into 9.81. So we have R to S 196.2 Newton force. Now the friction F2 will be equal to mu into R2. Okay, so 0.3 into 196.2, friction is 58.86. Okay, now we have to find out the equilibrium of all the forces in the horizontal direction. So we have F2, MA and T. So we have F2 plus MA equal to T. Okay, so solving and simplifying, we have T minus 20A is equal to 58.86 Newtons. Okay, so we have two simultaneous equation in terms of T and A. By solving both of them, we can find out the tension as well as the acceleration. So we get tension as 18 Newton and acceleration as 1.057 meter per second square. So that is a simple problem on a connected bodies. Okay, I have written more problems for you to solve. You can solve it as assignment. So I'll give a hint here. So here there are two connected bodies and then there is a pulley here, so you can slide. Also the every surface is having equal coefficient of friction 0.3. so here mass of A is more than mass of B. Also slope at A is more than slope at B, so which means that motion will be towards left. Okay, this body will also move towards left. So you can see that you have to apply friction in the opposite direction in both the cases. Also you have to take the component of weight in the x direction. Also you have to find out the component of the weight in the y this direction. Okay, and you have to solve. Okay, so try this problem as an assignment. So the weight will be acting downward, its component along the slope will be contributing towards the motion, and the component towards perpendicular to the slope surface will be contributing to the reaction. So we have an upward reaction here, and R into mu will be actually the friction. So you try to solve this example by your own. Okay, similarly you can do it here also. Okay, so this is again another example for connected body motion, again in an inclined surface, but here the distance between the two parts is given, which means that S is given, A is not given. You have to find out the A acceleration in this case, and once acceleration obtained, you have to find out the time required for both of them to touch each other. Okay, so this is very easy problem making. And finally, I have included one more elevator problem. You can solve it easily. Clear? So I'll go give all these questions as assignment. So go through the assignment and submit the assignment later.